Since this is only a 12-minute long short film, I intended to make the review also a lot shorter. But as you can see by the length of the video, I failed. Servus Freunde, my name is Jimmy Cage, and because this year marks the 100th birthday of legendary filmmaker Satyajit Ray, we are watching and reviewing at least one of his many great films every month. At this point, we have already reviewed more than 10 of his films, and it was no surprise to us that Ray has become one of our favorite filmmakers of all time. Over the past few months, he has also become one of my favorite authors, and I have read several of his wonderful short stories. When it comes to short movies, today marks a first. Because I have never talked about another short on the channel before, or at least I can't remember doing so. But this one was recommended to us quite a lot, and because it's a Satyajit Ray film, I couldn't resist. Two came out in 1964, and it was part of a trilogy of short films from India that were commissioned by a non-profit US public television service under the banner Esso World Theatre. Luckily for us, Ray's short has been restored by the Academy of Motion Pictures, Arts and Sciences, and everyone can and everyone should watch it for free on the official Oscars YouTube channel. You can find a link to it in the description below. When it comes to Satyajit Ray, the most obvious entry point to explore his filmography is of course his debut film Pata Panchali from 1955. But if you want a small tease of his wonderful artistry, I would strongly recommend watching this downright perfect short film. Two is only 12 minutes long, but there is so much packed into those 12 minutes. And it's told in such a remarkable, genius way that I can only praise it in the highest regards. Ray was asked to make a movie in English, set in Bengal. And on the latter part, he delivered. But he also decided to make it completely without any dialogue, without any spoken words. Now, should I give you a spoiler warning? I mean, it's a short film and I will talk about all of it. So if you don't want to know anything, just go watch it. You won't regret it. And in case you wonder just how good it is, I don't think I want to start rating short films as well, but if I would do that, then 2 would probably be a 10 out of 10. More like 9.6. But then again, I don't do that. Alright, 2 tells the story of two young boys. One is rich and lives in this giant estate, and the other one seems to be a boy from the slums, who has also much darker skin. The short begins with the rich kid, waving goodbye to a leaving car, probably his parents. And then he's just wandering around in his house, where you can see the aftermath of a birthday party. He's putting fire to some of his balloons, which make them pop, and then we can see some of his many toys. Everything that we see and hear points to him being fairly spoiled. Like in almost all of his films, the score was composed by Ray himself, and we get this nice little, rather carefree tune that then gets faded out by the sounds of the kids' toys and by the playing of a flute from the off. This is when the boy discovers the other child, who is playing the flute outside the house. And this encounter, this wordless encounter, is what the short is all about. It quickly becomes this one-upmanship between the two, or maybe rather by the rich kid who wants to impress the other with all of his expensive toys and gadgets. The storytelling and filmmaking are absolutely masterful. It was of course also written by Ray, with cinematography by Zumendu Roy and editing by Dulal Dutta. And of course these two child actors who are doing a terrific job in making their characters feel real and making that little but very rich story so engaging. The film is filled with symbolism and it is so easy to connect to and yet so deep and profound. We have these two kids who are probably the same age, but they are coming from two very different social classes. It is a tale of upper and lower class. Also quite literally, with the rich boy looking down from the window and the poor boy having his feet on the earth looking up. It is about dominance and envy, about materialism and happiness. When the rich boy sees the poor one playing the flute, he rushes back and gets his own instrument. When the poor one gets his drums, the rich one gets his monkey toy, who plays the drums. He keeps showing off all of his things, but it can also be noted that I don't think that he's a clear villain. I mean, he's just a kid. And I think most of us can also rather easily relate to him as well, especially since the movie begins from his perspective. And I think we have all been boastful and bratty at some point in our lives. But of course the short film goes deeper than that, and it can very easily be read as a criticism of classism and how the privileged are treating the non-privileged. The rich boy has the urge to demonstrate his superiority, and it also seems as if all the toys in the world can make him happy. And he can't accept to see the other boy smile and play with a toy that he can't compete with. While the poor child is out in the open, out under the sun, playing with his kite, the rich kid is behind his window, and with its bars it is easy to make the connection to a prison, to being locked in. And when he has no way to compete with the kite, he takes his gun and shoots it down. Envy and greed are part of the human condition, and the rich oftentimes don't want to let anything for the poor, especially if they can't have it for themselves. The reaction of the poor child when his kite has been shot down is so heartfelt, and once again you can see Ray's masterful sensibility and his great way of working with children. It is a really touching moment. But instead of having won the day, when the rich one is activating all of his fancy, expensive toys, we and he can hear that flute once again. The flute that started their encounter. Instead of having broken down the spirit of the poor child, he is still prevailing and playing his flute. And the rich one feels his defeat, while his little robot is crashing into his symbolic ivory tower. And with that, the 12 minutes are over and Ray has created one of the most wonderful and most profound short films in the history of cinema. Or in the history of television, I guess. It has been noted that 2 is also making a strong anti-war statement, because it was made during the Vietnam War, and because you could very easily attribute the rich boy to the United States, with all their materialistic nature, especially the Mickey Mouse-like ears of the young boy, and the poor one to the Viet Cong, who don't have the same means, but whose spirit is also prevailing. It's just an all-in-all tremendous film, so go watch it. Alright, that's it like always. Comment below and let me know what you think about 2. And also let me know what is your favorite Indian short movie. You can hit me up on Twitter, Instagram and Letterboxd and also on Patreon simply at The Jimmy Cage. And if you enjoyed this episode, please give me a thumbs up, share, subscribe, whatever you like. And make sure you hit that bell for all I have to tell.